In part one of this series, we learned about corona and its effect on the power system. Now we will learn about how corona can be measured. Each year, utilities invest billions of dollars to upgrade existing high-voltage transmission lines and to build new ones. As we discussed earlier, it is important that these lines be as free as possible of corona and the noise and interference it causes. For this reason, all transmission line hardware must be tested to demonstrate it is corona-free before it can be deployed on the power system.
This is a transmission line spacer damper. It's used to ensure that the spacing of the wires that make up a transmission line are proper. And this may look like a simple device, but it's actually precisely engineered. And one of the criteria that it has to meet is that it be corona-free.
This is a spacer damper that must meet exact standards specified by the utility. One such requirement is that it be corona-free for a voltage 15% higher than that of the line on which it will be used. But how can we measure that to demonstrate whether it meets the requirement? Such tests are usually carried out at a high-voltage laboratory such as the Bonneville Power Administration's High Voltage Laboratory in Vancouver, Washington. The hardware, in this case a spacer damper, is installed on a full-scale transmission line mock-up in the laboratory. It can then be energized with high voltage using a specialized test transformer. Since corona emits light, sound, and radio interference, that gives us at least three ways of measuring it. This is a sound pressure level meter. As you can see, it responds to the intensity of the sound.
Can you do that one more time where you come down to 300 and back up, please?
All right, 300 kV.
Since we can darken the inside of the high voltage lab, we can see the corona either directly or with the help of a night vision scope. This is called the visual corona method.
Bring the voltage up to 400 kV and turn the lights out.
One advantage of this method is that we can see the precise location that is causing the corona, which makes solving the problem a lot easier. One interesting thing you learn after watching corona for a while is that there are two basic types of corona, positive and negative. The negative or glow corona doesn't require as much voltage and isn't as disruptive. Positive or plume corona generally requires more voltage and produces more noise, light, and radio interference. A specialized AM radio can be used to quantify a corona source. First, the laboratory must be free of other radio noise to ensure that what the radio picks up is actually caused by the equipment being tested. Then, a voltage is applied and the radio noise can be measured and recorded in microvolts. Industry standards specify acceptable levels of radio noise for a given type of hardware.
It detects ultraviolet light in a spectrum that corona emits.
One innovative new way to detect corona is with a daylight corona camera. We know that corona emits light, and that if it is dark enough, we can see that light. However, it is impractical to inspect a real power line in this way because of sunlight, moonlight, or man-made light sources that may mask the corona light. It turns out that corona emits light in the ultraviolet spectrum that is not commonly found in sunlight or man-made light. The daylight corona camera takes advantage of this and is able to display a dot on the image where it detects this ultraviolet light. As you can see, we have many options to determine how much corona there is, what type, and where it is coming from. This information helps utility engineers to design, build, operate, and maintain transmission lines that are free of the nuisance of corona.